just me and my guitar.
Hi guys, we're back. Okay, like I said, we're going to cover a few things today. Now with this koi pond, obviously there's nothing in it at all, apart from the koi, the waterfall and the filter, because we want to keep it clean, we want to keep it healthy for the fish, and we want to see the fish. It's just the way I've designed and the way I've chose to have this pond, with no plants in. Koi are quite destructive fish, and if you've got pots in, they can uproot things, pull lilies out and various other plants and eat them, or just suck all the ground out and make a right mess in your pond. So with this, I've just tried to keep everything as clean as possible so I can just enjoy the fish for them in their environment. And like you say, with the waterfall and just be in the garden and listen to that and everything else. But what we will look at down here is your air pumps. Now, I'm not sure if you know, if you've got one of these big air pumps on your pond for the that's run your air stones, your filters and all that stuff. Underneath here, if we take that off, you'll see you've got a filter pad under there, look. Now that can get quite clogged up because it sucks through that and down into your filter, and then it obviously down through the airline and into your pond out through the air stone. Make sure that's all cleaned out. You can give it a smack or you can wash it out. You'll find you get quite a lot of dust particle and stuff build up in there. You can see this one needs doing. That's what I'm showing you. So you see, you just rinse them out, squash them out some time. You see the dust coming off of that now, look. No end of dust coming off of that. And sometimes you will get that corrosion around there as well. Obviously this is quite an old pump. But so that's a job that can always be done in the spring. So, you know, I mean, you can do that anytime. It's not an important one. But that's just something that some people overlook and they don't realise that there's actually a filter in there at all. And I've known a mate of mine who's had one for years and he's never even cleaned it out. And you wonder why it wasn't working very well. And he had all sorts of bugs had stuck in there and all kinds of stuff. But so make sure that's one you can do. Obviously as well, check all your fittings, all your pipe fittings, make sure they're all tight, nothing's leaking. Just go all through them. On one of my other videos, I'm not sure if I've put it up yet, but this sequence pump was running absolutely useless. And I thought, well, that's a bit strange because the water level was going down a bit. I'd give it a partial water change and noticed it wasn't coming out very well. So I took it apart by taking that off there and that one there, drained everything out. And inside here, inside the impeller casing, it was absolutely rammed with bits of stick, leaves. There was even a couple of dead mice in there, which wasn't very nice. And that was the reason, because it was blocked up and it wasn't working very well and very efficiently at all. So I took that outside, I put the jet washer on it, we cleaned all that up. Re-PTFE taped this joint here, that's a screw-in joint, as is this one here, and put it all back together, and the water's absolutely flying through there now and giving a really good circulation again. So that was something that I overlooked, and it's nicer when you can do it early in the season because you're not going to upset your fish too much and put them off. So that was all done. Another thing to do with this pond is the UVs. Now the bulb, I will change this bulb in another month's time. Change them every 6 months. If you look around the side there, you can see if it's still working or not by that visual inspection hatch there. You take that out. If you want to clean things out, that's your bulb and your casing there underneath. That cover's split, but it's not outside, so that's not going to make any difference. Always make sure I put that to the bottom. Never look at the UV light as well, because you can damage your eyesight quite badly with those. So there's another thing you've got to do. Every 6 months, change your UV bulb. And this is my koi pond. This is what I do, maintenance-wise. Obviously, the filter as well is outside. You can see that on my other videos, if you go back and have a look. It's a Nexus 220, which I've got outside. There's a picture of, I've got a video of me actually cleaning that one. Cleaning it out, back flushing it and what have you. So you can check that one out if you have got one and you're thinking of getting one. Right, I think we'll leave this little pond now. Well, what I will say as well, I've got this pond, this certain pond, is on a drip feed. You see, it's on a permanent drip feed going through there, which runs off of an Aqua Evolution, or an Evolution Aqua, I should have said, big carbon block filter, which I've got under my shed bench here, which you can see there. That's good for about 350,000 gallons, that is. And that's on a constant run through there all the time. And that takes out all the chlorines, chloramines, and all the nasties out the water system. And so it puts some nice clear water into your pond. And so that's on a constant drip all the time. So once I've done a couple of spring biggish water changes, I only have that trickle on through the summer. I don't have it on in the winter time, obviously, because that's adding cold water constantly to it. And I've got the covers on, so it'll fluctuate the temperature. So I don't have that on in the summer. Sorry, in the winter. In the summer, I put it on. So that's on a constant drip now, so I won't be giving this a water change now for the whole summer, as that's just constantly flowing through there and going out through a drain, through the skimmer there, and down into the sewer. So that's done. Right, I think we'll move on now. I've got a little tiny pond out the front of my house, which I don't think anyone's seen yet. So we'll nip out the front now and we'll take a look at that. There you go, guys. There's the front little pond. This is what I made up a couple of years ago now, out of a little vat. I'll give you a video on how I built this one, but just at the moment, I'll just show you the plants I've got in there. Got some horse tails in there, some pitcher plants. And there's an iris in there as well, variegated iris coming up. And in here, I've just got some bog standard goldie fish. I'm running it off a little canister filter there. In amongst all these lovely bulbs that's come up. Look at that. They look lovely, don't they? All the baskets, different plants in. The old strawberries are cracking out again, which is nice. But yes, with this kind of a pond, what I tend to do in the spring, like now, it's because it's just goldfish in there. It's got a lily in there, which is coming out. I don't know if you can see it. You can just see those lily pads starting to come out. And these little floating baskets, which are quite good. I do a water change in this one every couple of, probably once a month, I would say. But I've just got an old trough there. What was one of these recycling troughs. And I just put some stone on it. Underneath, I drilled a series of holes and I filled it full of alpha grog, which is a type of media which you can use in koi filters and different types of vortex filters and what have you. And I just filled it up with that. So it's actually acting as it fills up now, goes through the media and then comes back out into the pond. So it's a bit of a filter, works as a filter as well. You see the goldfish hiding under there. Now I'm lucky with this pond because I've got that big carbon block filter in there, and all I've got to do is stick another hose pipe on that and run it from the shed out here and fill it up with this. So I don't need to bother with tap chlorinate dechlorinators and stuff like that. But if you haven't got that carbon block filter, you're going to have to put some tap water conditioner in there. Just make sure you mix it up in a vat or in a bucket or whatever you've got to do, and put it in for the gallonage and follow the instructions and make sure that you get the chlorine out of the water. Otherwise you're going to be killing off any beneficial bacteria in your systems, which you don't want. You want that thriving, especially in the spring, as everything is low after the winter period. Everything's still sleepy and it's slowly waking up. Bacteria's waking up, the fish are waking up, you start feeding them, and obviously all those ammonias and things will start being present again in the water, and nitrites. So get on top of that, get yourself some water conditioner. Now if this pond is in full sun, so in the spring it does suffer with a bit of blanket weed. But what I tend to do in this one is you can buy barley straw in a little packet in your local fish shop, or unless you're lucky enough to find it somewhere where it's clean and it's not going to be sprayed with anything. And you can make a little basket of that up, or tie some together with some string and a little stone in between it, and sink it in your pond. And that'll help with that. That's what I use in this little pond here. So just to take a little back step there. Everything else is fine. You just put some, make sure you get your tap water conditioner. You do your regular water changes if you're feeding your fish regularly. And just enjoy it. Sit outside with a glass of wine and listen to the water. This one's running a bit slow. Make sure you want to go to the toilet. I'll turn it on a bit more, I think. It's a good thing as I plumbed it into this tap so I can actually turn it on faster or slower. There you go, that's better. I've got some Himalayan poppies coming out here, which have got beautiful big blue flowers on them when they come out. There's something to see. I think they last about 2 years, these guys. And I think my horsetail, needs a bit of a prune back there. The wind has been a bit moody and knocked them over. And so I'll cut those back, I think, and we'll get some fresh growth coming up. That's actually been on that all winter. It hasn't died back at all. As with that, it just had its leaves. Now it's just starting to move and grow out of itself. There's a few little baby shoots coming out of the bottom there. And my fish are still very spooky. But they'll come up later on. They'll be up feeding out meanders like they do every year. There's a nice Franks in there. I don't know if you can see him. He's a big fat aranda. Here he comes. Watch out, Frank. He's got a bit of a sore on his side there, which is, we're gonna have to have a look at that. Take him out and give him a treatment and sort him out before. That's another thing as well. All your immune systems in your fish are down as well. So when you start feeding them, make sure you feed them weak germ early in the spring. Preferably with garlic in, which will help their immune systems and boost them back up to speed again. Before the weather warms up, make sure it gets about, I don't know, I always say about 13 to 14 degrees, and then you can start feeding them a bit more food with a bit more protein in it and slowly build them up then. But don't feed them high protein food straight away in the start of the year. That's very important, because if you do have a cold snap, it's hard to digest. And you will trap it in their stomach and it'll hurt them, it'll gas them up, and you'll start losing fish that way. Even this time of the year now, even in April, we can still get these frosts. And in a small pond like this, it can really drop the temperature quickly. Like my big koi pond there rarely moves because it's under the ground and it holds the ground temperature, so it's more stable. Right, I think we should go up and look at my old pond now. I've got a 30-year-old small pond up in my back garden, so we'll go and look at that and we'll have a quick chat about that one. All right, guys, we're in the back garden. Now this pond, like I said, it's about 30 years old. Now with this pond, I don't actually do anything to it at all. Nothing whatsoever. Take out a few branches that fall down from the trees and accidentally go in there sometimes. But apart from that, I leave it alone. It's just a nature pond. So the leaves go in, they rot down, and I just let nature take its course. It's absolutely full of newts and frogs. There's toads in there. So if you've got a wildlife pond, you don't really want to be messing around with it in the spring, like sucking out or putting hoovers in it, you know, getting the leaves out and all that sort of stuff, because early in the spring, all these things are starting to lay eggs. The newts, the frogs, they're all laying eggs, and they're getting ready all their babies to have a new start in the season. So you don't really want to go playing around in an old pond like this. There's quite a few flowers coming up around the place now as well. There's a nice mosaic plant in there as well at the back there. There's some creeping Jenny, which is always nice. That comes creeping out. It's not really actually that much of it around at the moment. It tends to come out a bit later and it'll cover all the rocks. There's lots of sphagnum moss around on the rocks as well. There's some taro in there as well. Absolutely, as you can see, duckweed everywhere. Loads of duckweed. There was some lettuce in there as well, some water lettuce, which does survive through the hotter months. It's the stuff you can buy in the garden centres, and that pops up in there. But I do tend to put some in every now and again. It doesn't last in there. So there's a blue iris as well, which comes out, which looks stunning. Everything's obviously, it's still coming out at the moment, so we're still pretty early in the season, but this is why we've got to get all these things done. But like I said, don't play with these sort of ponds if you've got a wildlife pond, or if you've just taken over a house that's got an old pond in it. It depends on you, really. It depends what you want. If you're happy with it as it is, leave it. But if you want to change it into something different, then that's your choice. But if it's an old pond and you're happy with it, just leave it alone. Don't do too much to it. Just play with the plants around the borders. And if you want to maybe add a lily to it or something like that, you can just sink a small pot into it with a different type of lily in there. But get the right lily for your ponds as well, because there's so many different types of lilies now. Some of them grow absolutely gigantic and it will fill this pond up in 2 years, and you won't have any water in it. It'll just be just all lilies. So be careful. You can get dwarf varieties of lilies, which you can put in there, which look really nice, various colours. I don't know what else I've got around in here, which comes out. I think I've got a red cardinal as well. That comes out every year. That looks quite pretty stunning. But apart from the moss and everything else, I've got a few honeysuckles, which grow up around the trees. They flower nicely as well, pink flowers. But like I say, I don't tend to play with this pond much because it's absolutely full of newts. And if you disturb the top of the water sometimes, you'll see them all jumping around, and they'll be hiding under the rocks in the side, as the frogs do as well. There's probably loads of tadpoles in here already by now. UV lights are amazing in ponds, especially in new ponds and in small ponds in low light or in high light, because they get rid of the algae. They kill the algae spores off. If you've got a filter, a little filter box with sponges in, you get little black ones that you can buy from the shop, and you put the pond pump in the pond and it pumps the water out into the box, and then it comes back out via a tube back into the pond. If you can buy an inline, you can buy the box filters with them actually in, built in, but if you haven't, if you can't afford one of those and maybe you come across a cheaper one on eBay or something like that, you can always put that inline, because it's just literally a pipe going in through it and out the other side back into the filter system. And what that does is it kills off and it makes the algae spores clump together. And what by doing that, it kills them off, they clump together, and then your filter can actually filter them out. So then that gets rid of the, that'll get rid of some of your green water as well. Because spring, you always get algae blooms first thing in the year. When you get the new sunshine coming in the ponds, kicks everything into gear, everything starts growing again and you get these algae blooms. But that's just part of having a pond. Old established ponds don't tend to suffer that much because they've got a good biological action running through them anyway. But if you've got a new build and you've just filled it up with water and you put a few plants in there, odds are you're going to get a big algae bloom in there. But don't worry about it too much, it will clear, and you'll get on top of it in the end. It's like anything, it all takes time to get established and to settle in. Right, we're going to go downstairs now and I'll give you one last look at the koi, and then we'll call that one a day, I think. Okay guys, we're back into the koi room again, part of my shed. Hope you enjoyed that little video on different things that you've got to sort out. I say there's so much to cover. That's just a little brief look into what you've got to do, and which can help you out on the oncoming season. Like I say, check all your pumps, your UV bulbs, if you've got established ponds, and if you've got a new build coming up as well, I would say think it through wisely first. Do plenty of homework before you start digging a pond. Plan it properly. Buy the best gear that you can possibly get hold of, and then you'll be doing a job once. Because there's nothing worse than getting halfway through a job and thinking, oh, when you finished it and thinking, oh, if only I'd plumbed in that bigger pipe or that bigger pump, or that bottom drain instead of a canister filter, or that instead of this. And you won't have that rattling around then in the back of your mind all the time thinking, oh, if only. So think it out, think it well, work it out properly, and happen, make it happen right the first time. Right, you lovely lot, I'm gonna leave you now. Just goodbye from me, goodbye from the koi and the ponds. Hopefully see you on the next video. Please like, share, and subscribe. If you like the videos, give them a thumbs up and all that stuff. And as I always say, you're all stars. Thank you for subscribing. Look after yourselves. Take care. And I'll see you on the next video. Bye for now. Just me and my guitar.